Thai National Innovation makes history with the first 50 ByeByeHIV cases in the world. Dear viewers, this coming December 1st is World AIDS Day. The World Health Organization has designated it as a day to raise awareness among the world's population about the dangers of AIDS and to join hands to campaign for improved quality of life for those infected by the disease and to promote the development of various innovations in treating AIDS. Thailand can be considered very fortunate. It is acknowledged as one of the countries in the world that has made significant progress in the development of innovations related to the efficacy for and prevention of HIV and AIDS. This progress has brought hope to patients worldwide. A team of Thai researchers under Operation BIM conducted research on extracts from edible plants that have been found to help infected individuals achieve a condition of undetectable HIV, which we refer to as ByeByeHIV, marking the first 50 cases in the world. What are the details and origin of this project? Today, we will talk with Dr.Pichaet Viriyachitra, the head of the Operation BIM research team. Hello, Dr.Pichaet. Could you tell us more about this ByeByeHIV project?
At the moment, we have successfully treated 50 cases using our immunotherapy innovation, resulting in no detectable virus over an extended period. And these individuals who have achieved ByeByeHIV enjoy robust health. Even after discontinuing the use of our immunotherapy, they continue to maintain the state of ByeByeHIV, showing no detectable virus. We believe that, following the success in these 50 cases, it's time to confidently announce that our immunotherapy innovation can indeed bring about the condition of ByeByeHIV. We have been campaigning for society to stop stigmatizing people infected with HIV and to open opportunities for them. We are giving those who have helped achieve ByeByeHIV the chance to rebuild their lives with pride by becoming experts in consulting other infected individuals to also achieve ByebyeHIV.
So that we will have more than 50 people who have achieved ByeByeHIV?
Absolutely. Through our publicity efforts, infected individuals have reached out to us. Currently, we have 24 people who have achieved ByeByeHIV, regaining health and strength solely through our ByeByeHIV immunotherapy. They continue to maintain their health and strength with undetectable HIV test results. The case you see here is Mr. Din, who, when he came in to see us for the first time, appeared lifeless, like a walking corpse. Mr. Din, please present your case to the viewers.
Hello, Mr. Din. There can be many causes of HIV infection. Some people acquire it from birth, and others, like you, Mr. Din, contract it through their jobs while assisting patients. You have sacrificed yourself for others. When you first met Dr.Pichaet, what was your physical condition like?
At that time, due to a blood infection and a swelling in both my neck and groin, the doctor initially thought it was tuberculosis of the lymph nodes. He started giving me medicines to treat tuberculosis and antibiotics simultaneously, but I was allergic to both. My body did not respond well to the treatment, so the doctor decided to conduct additional blood tests, which revealed that I was infected with HIV.
How long did it take for the allergic reactions to occur while taking the medication?
It took less than 3 days to have an allergic reaction. The reaction was so severe that the skin peeled off all over my body, becoming dry and dark. After the test confirmed that I had HIV, my CD4 count was only 4, nearly depleted, whereas a normal person should have at least 600 to 1,800. As for the CD4 percentage, which a normal person must have at least 30%, I had only 0.7%. My HIV viral load was over 2.5 million copies in 1 milliliter.
What is this photo?
This is a photo at the time of my hospital treatment, showing the allergic reaction to tuberculosis treatment, where the skin peeled off, became dry and dark.
But the you we see today is so different. Dear viewers, Mr. Din's skin now looks fantastic, so bright and healthy. At the time when you were in such a dire condition, did you feel discouraged with no hope?
At that time, I was feeling totally hopeless because I thought my life was probably ending soon, with people who came to visit me gossiping that I would surely die.
Typically, when we hear others talk about us in that manner, many people would be discouraged. But what was it inside you that assured you there was still hope?
The encouragement from my family is my source of strength. As a pillar of the family, I have to take care of my mother and everyone. When my mother said, "You'll get better soon," I echoed those words to myself, smiled, and that brought a smile to my mother's face as well. Additionally, through the grace of merit, I got to know Dr. Chandit Kotiranrak, who advised me to seek guidance on the use of immunotherapy.
Who is Dr. Chandit?
He is a doctor based at a public hospital. He suggested that I consult with Dr.Pichaet and his assistant, Ms. Ad Siripon, regarding the use of immunotherapy and healthcare. I would like to express my deep gratitude to Dr.Pichaet and Ms. Ad Siripon for their strong guidance on how to take care of myself, which resulted in remarkable improvements.
Dr.Pichaet, what were your initial feelings when you first met Mr. Din?
Hopelessly beyond description. But because we knew and respected Dr. Chandit, who sent Mr. Din to us, we had to do our best. We devised a treatment plan and I assigned Ms. Ad to give special focus to his case.
I understand that Dr. Pichaet's immunotherapy innovation involves a mixture of extracts from five types of plants. While receiving the immunotherapy, did you have to stop the medications you were previously taking, Mr. Din?
I used hospital medicine alongside immunotherapy, but I didn't start antiviral medication due to my weakened condition from blood infection and tuberculosis drug allergy. I needed to rehabilitate my health first.
So the primary treatment at that time was Dr. Pichaet's immunotherapy?
Yes, along with strict healthcare guidance from Dr. Pichaet's assistant, Ms. Ad Siripon.
Did you begin to see some results after, say, 3 months?
I started seeing results from the first week.
What were the improvements in the first week?
Before starting the immunotherapy, I felt weak, tired, and had difficulty walking. Then, during the first week of the immunotherapy, I began to feel that my body was getting stronger and I could walk to the bathroom by myself. During that time, I had a fever of 39 to 40 degrees Celsius, and the nurses were shocked to see me going to the bathroom and taking a shower by myself. Just before the start of the immunotherapy, I had already lost 22 kilos from 62 down to 40 kilos. But 3 months after the immunotherapy, my weight went up to 57 kilos. And after 9 months, it reached 76 kilos.
I would like Dr. Pichaet to explain a little bit here. Just from the naked eye, without looking at the level of genes, chromosomes, or the infected white blood cells, we can see an improvement in his skin condition after 3 months. Why is this? What effect do the mixture of five plant extracts have on our bodies?
Besides killing the HIV virus, it also stimulates the repair of telomeres that have been damaged by HIV. As reflected initially in the skin, they became darkened and wrinkled, and then followed by many other side effects.
Stimulating telomere repair helps to improve the skin complexion.
This was a difficult case. We provided full care and regular checks up for the infection before we could declare success after a period of time.
We can observe improvements in the visible parts of Mr. Din from the photos of his body. After 3 months, his skin had improved, and after 9 months, it was evident that he had become healthy and plump.
I'd like to interject here that at the beginning, due to numerous side effects from the antibiotics he was using, his CD4 was being destroyed, making it very difficult to stimulate his immune system. However, within 7 months, the HIV virus, which exceeded 2.5 million copies, was not detected in the test, giving us comfort.
The upper graph showed a sharp rise in CD4, while the lower graph exhibited a simultaneous sharp drop in the HIV load. The contrast is very clear. How many months has it been since your HIV was undetected?
No HIV infection has been detected continuously for 39 months.
Wow, that's over 3 years.
My latest CD4 count is 771 and CD4 percentage 30%.
comparable to that of a normal healthy individual. My body has become strong and healthy.
Mr. Dim, how long did it take for you to be able to live a normal life after the immunotherapy?
Around the first month, I felt that my body was getting stronger. I could eat better. When I was infected and still hospitalized, the food options were limited. I mostly had boiled rice, and my appetite was affected, causing gradual weight loss. Once I started using this immunotherapy, things improved. I regained my appetite, and with an improved mental state, it gave me the willpower to continue the fight.
Do you have any other cases?
Well, there are 26 cases of individuals who were using antiretroviral medicines and suffering from the side effects, but after using Dr.Pichaet's immunotherapy, they became undetected with HIV and could discontinue the use of antivirals while being healthy and strong. The case with the longest time of being HIV undetectable is 36 months. Moreover, three cases were able to remain HIV undetectable even after stopping Dr.Pichaet's immunotherapy.
In the case of those who were on antivirals and using our immunotherapy, we did not make them stop using the antivirals immediately, as there was a risk of a sharp rise in HIV load given their initial weak state of health. We have to boost their immune system first and help them recover from the side effects of the antivirals they were using. When we notice that they have started to become stronger, we gradually made them stop the antivirals within 6 months. We did this approach to all cases.
The next person that I would like to showcase in the following video is Miss View, who, like me, also works as an expert consultant for HIV-infected individuals.
Hello, my name is View. In 2016, I discovered that I had contracted HIV. During that time, my health was in a very poor state, with a CD4 count of only 72. I also suffered from various opportunistic diseases, the most severe being tuberculosis of the lymph nodes in my neck, which was excruciatingly painful. The medication I took had many side effects, including muscle atrophy in my limbs, fragile teeth, dizziness, tinnitus, and hair loss. My skin became dry and darkened, and I experienced pains in my joints and muscles. I faced weight loss and difficulty eating. I couldn't fall asleep and had nightmares. Additionally, I developed chronic kidney disease and fatty liver disease. Despite these challenges, I have now successfully recovered and enjoy robust health compared to that of a normal person. I have ceased using antiviral drugs and achieved ByeByeHIV for 6 months. Feel free to chat with me online at the line ID at APCOFC. Keep fighting and take care.
Miss View is another person who willingly devotes her time to provide advice to those who want to ByeByeHIV. With both Mr. Din and Ms. View working together to offer guidance to individuals wanting to overcome the challenges of HIV infection, our initiative has made great progress. This is the mission that we want to continue. Having addressed the physical treatment aspect of HIV, our focus now shifts to tackling the social problem related to HIV. Social prejudice against people who are or were once HIV infected has led to limited work opportunities for them. Thus, we want to contribute by providing jobs that involve assisting HIV infected individuals to those who have achieved ByeByeHIV, giving them the opportunity to make positive contributions to society. I can affirm that they are now contributing more to society than many of those who discriminate against them. Therefore, our plan is to further expand a community of individuals who have achieved ByeByeHIV through our immunotherapy innovation and offer them employment as consultants to assist other infected individuals. In addition, we are proud to report that thanks to our immunotherapy innovation, two HIV-infected cases, one infected from birth via the mother, and another with brain cancer for 9 years, have both achieved ByeByeHIV and returned to normal health in every way. What we have achieved here has given us confidence that this innovation by the Thai people has genuinely brought about the state of ByeByeHIV among those who were once infected with HIV. Therefore, as scientists, we must persist in this duty, as the responsible scientist's obligation is to create something good and beautiful for society.
You are bringing hope to the world, Dr. Pichaet.
When I see an opportunity to help people, I believe it is my duty to spread the word. Failing to do so is considered a sin. I want to express my gratitude to the many doctors who have been providing support for this work to help the HIV-infected community. They are the ones with an open mind to recognize that innovation can also come from Thai people in the field of immunotherapy.
If any of you viewers wish to get consultation, please call the number 1154 or at line at APCOFC. We would like to express our deep gratitude to both of you for joining us in this discussion today. Thank you very much.
More information is available at www.byebyehiv.com. Bye Bye HIV with Thai Innovation.